Ready. We got 365 on the bar. All I did was add a 10. So, we got. So I'm gonna get more into like talking about this video after I'm done working out. But pretty much it's back day. We're doing deadlift right now. It's the last thing. Trying to perfect my form, do things that I'm normally not doing, which I should be doing to have better form. One of my friends suggested that because I use lifting straps to do a double overhand instead of one underhand. So that's what I'm doing. Right now, my way up to, I did this at a 3 at 365. I got 380 on the bar right now. I got a 2.5, 5, 10, 25, 35, 245s. I'll do 4 sets because I haven't really like done back-to-back overhand, double overhand, and then the other grip on the same weight to try to see the difference. But I'm going to do that right now. I'm going to do this first set, double overhand. Second set will be one underhand, one overhand. I don't know what the grip's called. Conventional, maybe? No, conventional would probably be double overhand. But, and then third set will be double overhand. Fourth set will be the other grip. And then I'll get into this video, explain the video. Right now it's day, I think it was 88. 88, 89, 90. No, it's day 87, 84, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is day 88. Yep, this is day 88. When I first started working out, I think my first week or whatever. Well, I'll look at it after this, but I took pictures of like my body. Like my, I obviously had shorts on, but in different poses and stuff. No crazy fucking, you know, bodybuilder poses. I don't know how to do all that crazy shit, but like simple stuff, like I was flexing. And then on my legs, and it's about to be 3 months after I started, 90 days. So I'm gonna take more pictures and then I'll do a side-by-side comparisons. But let's get into this first set of 380. We'll do double overhand. Let me get a song on. Let's do Baby Rockstar. I just listened to this song today. I fuck with it. You know, it's about that shit going on in the world right now. Or all in the United States. I didn't really like that. The war ran. I did not like that. But I'm a look at my form after every like set. I look at my form. That's why I got it like a side view to see. Cause the big issue I have is I hurts my back. I'm totally trying to work on not doing that anymore. So I got the side view. After every set, I look at it so to see if I'm arching my back or not. This felt bad, like feel like I arched my back, but yeah. Nah, wasn't happening. It has been. So the reason I ain't uploaded a video in like a week and a half is because I was on a field op last week from like what was it? June 23rd to like the 30th. I got back on Monday night. And so this is my first back day, my third gym session since I got back. And all during the field op, oh yeah, with MREs. So I didn't really, my protein intake wasn't as much. Definitely wasn't able to cut. And I wasn't able to work out. So I guess it's kind of my fault for trying to do heavy after a week of no gym. But I did weigh in this morning at 197, which is my lowest weight so far. So I'm not gonna do four sets, obviously. I could barely do the second set. What I will say is that the first set, which I did a double overhand, was much easier than when I tried to do the second set of one underhand, one overhand. Because you see, I did one rep. And then the second rep, I had to put it down and, you know, readjust. And the third rep didn't even happen. Could just be that I was, you know, I did the most I could. But I will say that it was much easier bringing up the first set, double overhand, which is usually I don't do double overhand at all. Even when I warm up, I do one underhand, one overhand the whole way through, warm up to finish my deadlift workout. So I do think, at least for now, I want to do double overhand more often, because at least from this, you just looking at these two sets, double overhand was easier. I haven't looked at on the second and mostly the third rep of that first set of 380. I did notice my back was arching. I think I tried to do some shrug shit. I don't know. That was nasty. So I gotta work on that. But it has been my first back session in like a week and a half, so I'm not gonna make excuses about that, so I wanted to come going to my mom's house for the 4th of July, so I'm gonna be gone. I'm leaving tomorrow morning, come back Sunday night, so I'm not gonna be able to work out tomorrow, Saturday or Sunday. But I will be going to the track with my auntie and my brother, doing some cardio for Saturday and Sunday. Friday, Probably not, because I'm going to get home. I'm going to get to my mom's house the evening, like 6, 7 p.m. at the latest. So chill with my family Friday. I'll get up early Saturday morning, probably like 5:30. Take my brother to the track. We're going to do this workout that I did with my lieutenant. We were running up and down the football field, the 100 yards. We were doing sprints up and down, like sprint, 10, 15 second break, sprint back, 100 yards. We did that for a mile and a half, I fucking died. And then we did suicides, 0 to 100. Oh Lord Jesus, I couldn't even run. I was like slow jogging it. One, because I was cramping up in my legs. Cause I didn't really hydrate that day. I didn't know what was gonna happen until the afternoon. And I didn't know when exactly. He just said, I'll let you know. But we'll do that Saturday. And then Sunday morning, I don't know, we'll do something. Something. But I'm gonna try to record parts of it. But so Friday we're not gonna work out. Friday is tomorrow. Today is Thursday the 2nd. Tomorrow is Friday the 3rd. Friday we're gonna be driving the whole morning and afternoon. Saturday we have a workout in the morning. We'll do cardio in the morning. We got the 4th of July barbecue in the evening, so busy all day, and also celebrating Elena's birthday. Sunday, I'll work out in the morning, and we'll probably drive home at like noon, so be gone all day. And then Monday back to work, and we'll get back into our normal routine. I meal prepped the day after I got back. So I meal prepped Tuesday? Yeah, for Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, Fridays. I like Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. But obviously Saturday we have the barbecue. So I'm gonna try to save it so that I can use it on Monday. So that then I can meal prep all Monday, so the following week, to get back on my meal prep schedule. But So I'm gonna put this weight away, and we'll take pictures of my body after 3 months. It's not as good as it should be, because 1 week in the field, just MREs, heavy carbs, heavy fat food, and I wasn't cutting, so yeah. But
close my eyes and contemplate, oh, I chose to be great. I find myself trying to escape from where I'm supposed to be safe. Yeah. Or maybe I should pray like I'm supposed to be saved. Sometimes I feel like getting even, but I chose to behave. I'm mentally locked in a prison and I need bail. But the internet'll kill me quicker than the streets will. And if that shit doesn't kill me, then the police will. Or maybe all the refills on the e-pills or the lean will. I wish I was more flourished. I wish I had more courage. I feel like there's more purpose. And maybe it's all worth it. I wanna keep on learning, but I couldn't be more nervous when I keep looking for answers. And I gotta keep on searching, the tables keep on turning. Try to call up the Jesus, but the phone keep on ringing. I think I need more service, the calls seem more urgent. And all I see is more murders, the soldiers keep on serving. I wonder if it's all worth it, I wonder.
All I need.